Hey, what is up guys? Bonfiggy here, and today I'm bringing you guys probably one of my best gameplays to date. This is actually the very first ever triple maul that I've gotten, and it was with a P90, so it's a little bit different weapon. I haven't uploaded too many gameplays with this gun, so I thought you guys might enjoy that. And also, it was my fastest triple maul to date. I believe I have 4 triple maul in total, and out of those 4, this was the fastest one. The first maul was like 1 minute and 50 seconds, then the second maul was like 100 seconds, and the third maul I definitely did take a little bit slower because I played extremely aggressive for the first half of the game. I think at like 110 points I had the double, and then I was going for the triple by then, so I did take a little bit slower. I just played a little bit more passive than I normally would have, and I could have gotten even faster if I would just would have been a little bit more rush happy on the third mob streak. But either way, I'm not complaining. It was still like 5.5-6 minutes for all 3 mob streaks, so I thought this was a really great gameplay. I hope you guys enjoy in the background. Now, one thing I want to go over real quick is my class setup. I was using the P90 with Silencer Rapid Fire. First perk was Scavenger Pro, second perk was Hardline Pro, and I really like to use that when I play Domination because the assists really do start to add up, and they definitely do help when you're going for your Moab streaks and everything. They can mean the difference between a Moab or not a Moab, so definitely would recommend that. And you guys would think that I was using Steady Aim with the P90, but I was actually using Sit Rep because I find that with the P90, without even Steady Aim, it already has great hip fire, so I definitely would recommend Sit Rep, especially on a map like Mission, because you can really hear footsteps pretty well on this map. So that's just one recommendation. Then my specialist bonus, as you guys can see, is sleight of hand, dead silence, quick draw. That's just my class setup real quick. And actually, there was a few people last video that wanted me to give my opinion on support runners. Now, the first thing that I want to talk about is whether or not it still makes the gameplay impressive. And I want to agree with you guys on this one because I definitely do think that if you do have support runners, the gameplay is not as impressive as it would be when you're playing solo without any support runners. And that's the reason why this is my very best gameplay to date. It definitely is probably one of my best, but probably my second, because my first best gameplay to date is the triple maul with no support. That's always going to be my best gameplay unless I drop like a quad maul with no support runners, which I think would be pretty insane. I'm not sure if I would be able to do that or not. That's just my take, and a lot of people always think that if you have support runners, you know, they're just an automatic douchebag and, you know, you abuse your subscribers. That kind of came from Jay Nasty, and the reason why he does that is because he gets really frustrated with the game. I mean, I definitely do too, but I don't even have a mic, so I can't even like scream at my teammates. And either way, I love my subscribers and I would never scream at you guys. Now, I wanted to give you guys a little bit of an information, kind of background on this gameplay. I was actually running support for my subscribers as well. I was not forcing them. We were kind of just going in a pattern where, you know, I would run support for them for a while. I think there was a few of my teammates who were trying to go for a double moab, and they were helping me go for the triple moab, so we were kind of helping each other out. It's not like I was abusing them or whatever, and I play with subscribers all the time where we just run specialists and just go straight up getting moabs all the time. Now, as you guys can see, there is quite a few transitions on the second and third moab streaks because that's when I started to slow down my game a little bit, and that's one thing I want to talk about. When you're going for the triple, I like to go for the first two moabs fairly fast, but I want to give myself plenty of time for the triple moab because that's when I start getting really nervous, and you want to be able to give yourself as much time as possible so you don't have to rush through it and end up dying in a stupid way, anything like that. So that's just one thing that I like to do when I'm going for triple moabs. And another thing I do, this is kind of like a mental thing I guess I could give you guys a little bit of a tip on. If you're going for the triple, one thing you guys got to do, say you get the first moab, just pretend it didn't happen, pretend you don't even have that, then same thing with the second moab, so that way when you're on the third moab streak, you just pretty much pretend that you don't have any and you just play like you normally would, just keep your momentum going. So that's just one tip I can give you guys for the triple moabs. Obviously, it does take a little bit of skill to keep the streaks going and not die, but I do have to say support, it does help you stay alive when you're on those moab streaks, and it just eliminates a lot of the bullshit of the game. For example, things you can't control such as Dead Man's Hand, Last Stand, just getting blop shot, something like that. The only thing it really doesn't avoid is getting panic knifed, and that's the worst feeling ever. Say you have a blitzing vest on, you just get knifed right through, that sucks. But yeah, that's enough about the gameplay, guys. Real quick, I wanted to talk about motivation before this gameplay ends and kind of what motivates me. Also, I wanted to know, what is your favorite sports team? Because I actually went to the Cleveland Browns game yesterday. It was really fun, actually. I met up with a few real-life subscribers, which I didn't think I would ever get to the point where my channel was big enough to actually meet up with people in real life. I pretty much just tweeted out if anyone was at the Browns game, and a few of my subscribers were there, so that was really cool. And yeah, guys, just leave me a comment letting me know what your favorite sports team is. And also, let's try to hit 500 likes on this gameplay. I would really appreciate that, and I definitely do think it would deserve it because it's one of my best gameplays to date. I don't get a triple moab too often. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. One last thing about the motivation, what keeps me going, a lot of my friends have quit YouTube in the past few months of doing it, and a lot of it just due to a lack of motivation, which is really unfortunate, actually. Now, I am calling in all three of the Moabs, but, you know, all the support and likes that you guys give me, I really do appreciate, and that's what keeps me going, and that's what keeps other people going. I know Green Goblin HD, he's one person that's very active with this channel. I think he uploads like 1 to 2 videos a day, and that just shows that he really wants to grow on YouTube. You know, he's willing to put the time in, and that's the same with me, guys. So I hope you guys did enjoy the gameplay. That's pretty much it, and I hope you guys did enjoy. Please subscribe if you're new, and that's it. Peace out, guys.